Imagine actually being free of bruxism. Now, I know for a lot of people that's hard to do. They imagine their life's going to be filled with mouth guards and damaged teeth and expensive dentist bills, maybe Botox in the jaw. And it's just kind of hard to imagine getting past it. But does it actually have to be that way? Well, in my experience and my opinion, it certainly doesn't need to be that way. And to understand how you can get past bruxism and get over bruxism and get rid of bruxism, it's first important to understand the underlying causes. Now, I've made a couple of videos about that already, which you'll find on the channel. But just to give you kind of like the overview, it's thought that over 70% of people who suffer from bruxism, the cause of that is anxiety or stress. And I would say, at least from my experience, it's much higher than that. These emotional disturbances, this stress or anxiety, plays out throughout the night as grinding or clenching, or throughout the day if you happen to have daytime bruxism. And for different people, it obviously varies in intensity. Some people it's very mild and doesn't really require very much treatment, but for other people it can be a lot more serious. Some people can even grind their way right the way through their mouth guards, destroying them completely. And bruxism tends to get worse over time if not addressed and not treated. And obviously the side effects of this, you probably know for yourself, you know, cracked and damaged teeth and all the other things that go along with it, pain, perhaps not getting such good sleep, effects on mood and so on, perhaps even affecting relationships and so on. So it's something you really want to try and get a grip on quite quickly, and no doubt that's what you want to do if you're watching this video. So what can you do about it? Well, if stress and anxiety are the underlying causes of bruxism, then it makes logical sense that that's where we should start. So the question actually becomes, how can we alleviate and even remove stress and anxiety from our lives so that the bruxism is either completely healed or at least is significantly improved? So how can we address anxiety and stress? And I've actually recorded some other videos addressing both of those things in more detail. And of course, there's a lot of things we can do. Just to name a few, you know, the things that people often recommend, things like meditation, things like yoga, lots of things like improving our sleep, getting outside in the morning, getting sunlight in our eyes, taking a walk. There's a lot of things we can do which will help to bring down the anxiety, bring down stress, just from things we do in our everyday life. But probably the most effective way of dealing with it is to work with a professional that will listen and understand your exact circumstances, exactly what's going on for you, and then we'll be able to put a treatment plan together to help you to completely move past it. And, you know, which kind of therapy or which kind of treatment is the best for dealing with stress and anxiety? And helping people to bring it down, to control it, to manage it is hypnotherapy. And that's what I use with my clients with great success. And if you think about it, hypnotherapy, what it does perhaps differently than some other modalities, some other ways of working with people, is it works with the subconscious mind. It enables us to change some of the patterns that we have going on in our subconscious mind. And of course, bruxism itself, bruxing, is a subconscious activity. You don't intend to grind your teeth or clamp your teeth, whether that's in the day or at night. It's not an intention that you have, it's just something that happens. It happens unconsciously. Then maybe you become consciously aware of it. And certainly when you wake up or when you start to experience the pain or some of the other symptoms, you certainly do become conscious of it. But the activity itself is unconscious. So it makes sense to work with this unconscious part of our minds, to reprogram it, to change this particular behavior that's causing so much damage, and also to bring down those underlying causes of the anxiety and the stress, giving us either completely removing it from our life in the case of the anxiety, or finding new ways of dealing with and managing the stress so that it doesn't come out through that bruxing activity causing all those problems. If you're still watching this video, it probably means that you're ready now to move past this bruxism, to put it behind you. And that's really the reason I offer a free Zoom consultation with me, where we can talk about exactly what's going on for you, what your symptoms are, what's going on in your life, what other factors are playing out into your bruxism. And I can explain to you a little bit more about how I work using hypnotherapy and other techniques to work with the subconscious mind to change this very damaging behaviour. By the end of that session, you'll have had a chance to kind of explain everything that's going on, talk everything through, and you'll really understand how you can start to get control over these areas of your life which seem a little bit out of control, how you can start to take control back, how you can start to make the changes you need to make in order to put bruxism behind you. And you'll find that link down in the comments section. And before you go and do that, before you sign up for that call, please just give this video a quick like. That just helps other people to find it, helps other people to find support. It'd also be amazing if you wanted to subscribe to the channel so you can find other content, similar types of content about bruxism. And I'd love to hear from you down in the comments below. What kind of symptoms are you facing when you're dealing with the bruxism? How is that playing out for you in your life? What have you tried? What's worked? What hasn't worked? Any feedback you have, I would love to hear it in the video below. It'd be lovely to continue the conversation, and also for other people to be able to see your comments, be able to kind of learn and grow as well as you do that. So thank you so much for joining me, and I look forward to speaking to you soon. Again, if you'd like to take advantage of one of those free consultations, you'll find the link down below somewhere in the comments. Pleasure to speak to you, and I hope to very much speak to you soon. Take care for now. Bye-bye.